What is going on, friends? We are back with more World Cup. Gotta be a bit more quiet because people are sleeping. Ricardo playing for Team Europe. They are up 2-0 versus US West. Mobali bringing probably Mega Venusaur squad, but the Z Salamence haven't seen that in World Cup yet. Whew. I assume it's gonna be Solvest, Magnezone, Fizdev, Mew with Defog. Not sure about the Landris set. I mean, it could just be defensive, or it could be Scarf. It's either Scarf Land or Scarf Grin, I'm thinking, yeah. And Ricardo bringing Mega Lopunny. Nice bulky offense. I could see that being Volt Switch Mew. I know Ricardo likes that set. Z-move Thundereth or Z-move... I think this is Scarf Garchomp, yeah. So it's either Z-move Thundereth or Trent, but I'm leaning towards Z-move this. Scarf Rocks Jump or Rocks Trend? Not sure. Probably Rocks Trend. It could also be Rocks Mew. But Default Mew makes a bit more sense to me because you definitely need hazard control on this type of team, on those type of teams, yeah. Like, because you're way too weak to Spikes and, like, Rocks are also annoying. Yeah, Spikes hit 5 of the 6 mons. You definitely need hazard control. So yeah, Ricardo's gonna scout for the Scarf Ice Beam turn 1 here and switch out probably into Tangros or Mew. And if I'm Mob, I would probably click U-turn here if I'm Scarf Grin. Or he could get up a Spike if he has that. He clicks Scarf U-turn turn 1, yup. So he can go into his Landris slash Salamence here. Pretty sure Salamence carries Earthquake, yup. Goes on Landris and he's probably just gonna get up his Rocks. And Ricardo is probably gonna go into the Mew slash Tangros. Probably Mew. He goes Thundereth. Wow, that's a wild play, but it makes sense too because he was not going for Stone Edge there. But yeah, I'm thinking this Landris is defensive, because... Actually, I'm not sure. But he goes Heartland Magnezone on the obvious HP Ice, so Ricardo playing it safe there. Switching out onto Venusaur, scouting for Focus Blast, but Ricardo packing Volt Switch comes in handy for him, gets that momentum. So now he gets to bring in his... either his Mew or his Heatran. I don't think this would be Earthquake Venusaur, because... he already has this with Earthquake, and Gren can also... potentially have a water move for Tren. So he's probably gonna defog here with the Mew. Or throw off a Will-O-Wisp. He could also go for Will-O-Wisp, yep. As he's just gonna Sludge Bomb Fish for the poison, yep. He gets it first, right? That sucks. Oh my god. This is gonna be annoying because he doesn't have anything to get rid of status. He's just gonna, Okay, I thought he would defog. Defog slash Roost, obviously. So Mob is gonna U-turn out into his, probably into his own Mew or into his Magnezone to Volt Switch. He's probably gonna defog here, right? Oh, he just roosts, okay. I mean, the toxic is not gonna rack up because it's just regular poison. So he's very confident that he's a fast Landris if he went into Landris, or he's gonna switch back into something like into what? I don't know if he's willing to let this get burned. Maybe he's max speed Landris. Yeah, he's max speed and he goes for knockoff. Okay, that is surprising. I'm not sure what Landris this is, but it should be Z-move Mens. The Landris is maybe off plate. It's some sort of thought breaking set. Knockoff to get rid of the Shedshell and Skarmory, and yeah, for the Magnezone. This is probably potentially Mobali expecting stall from Ricardo. Does he not have defog on this Mew? I mean, he can't defog. This Mens is just too scary. Sky Strike might just kill the Mew. So this is a tough spot for Ricardo. What do you bring out here on the Sky Strike? I'm pretty sure that he's just gonna click the Z-move with the Mens. I don't see much reason to not click the Z-move here. Huh. He might go on a Heatran, but if this Dragon Dance is up, This could also be sub, but I don't think so. I think it's Dragonlance Aufkrieg, and Dragonclaw slash Outrage, and then Fly, obviously, with the Z-move. Yeah, this is tough for Ricardo. He really wants to get rid of the rocks for the Sandras. Oh, overall, rocks are just annoying for his team. But he might be forced to stay in here and go for Wisp. He is substitute. Oh my god, yeah, this game is over. This puts Mob in a really good position. So he's gonna Dragon Dance up, and if this Mew doesn't have Ice Beam, he just has U-turn. Okay, so I was thinking he had Voltage, but he had U-turn. So will Wisp boost U-turn? I think the last move should be Defog, right? Damn. This is such a fire set. I'm gonna be happy to put this in a thumbnail. So he's gonna go for Dragon Claw here. Or Dragon Dance again is obviously the better play. You wanna Dragon Dance again to outspeed everything. And now he can Dragon Claw in this game. So Ricardo's way of keeping this in check is potential Thunder Wave with Sandras now. And Fake Out from Lopunny to get some chip damage. But this game should be over now. I don't see how Ricardo can win this. He can hope that this doesn't have a move to touch Heatran. But if Heatran only has Magma Storm Toxic, it cannot break the sub, so this just subs again and the game is over. So maybe he has Rauntre and it would be clutch for Ricardo, but otherwise I don't see how he beats this other than having T-Wave on Dundee. Yeah, DD game was the correct play. I said Dragonclaw first, but DD is definitely the better play because he had a sub up, he didn't lose anything. And he outspeeds Scarf Jump. Now Scarf Jump is locked into Outrage, so Mob can probably go for Dragonclaw here. He might be Kalking if Earthquake kills, if he has Earthquake, but I'm pretty sure Earthquake doesn't kill. Wait, if he has Dragonclaw and Earthquake, he doesn't have Sky Strike. I'm confused. Maybe he's Z Dragon Salamence? I'm not sure. We shall see. This is definitely an interesting set. I mean, I had Thub in the back of my mind as an option, but I didn't think he would actually be packed that. But I think Mobali wins this game now. His team can definitely... This team definitely needs the win because they are back in the back 2-0, like I said earlier. They played DPP and GC so far, if I'm not mistaken. I didn't record those, yeah. It's 1:40 a.m. here, by the way. I don't know where Ricardo always plays late at night. But it's completely fine with me. I'm still awake. The problem would have been if he played in 1 or 2 hours. I didn't want to stay up all night. But yeah. If my brother runs... If the recording ends in a few seconds, it's because my brother runs in my room and like I have to stop because he's getting mad because he's trying to sleep next door. I mean if I don't sound that motivated, that's why, because my brother's sleeping next door and I'm like can't talk too loud, but I already said that. Yeah, he goes for a Z-move to not take rough skin damage. Okay, so maybe he doesn't have Dragon Claw. He's probably Z-Fly and the last slot Earthquake, because otherwise he would have gone for Dragon Claw, right? Took 45 seconds to click that. So he has to go into Thunderous and T-Wave if he has it. So he showed HPS and Volt Switch. So his other moves could be T-Wave and... What do they run in the last slot? Not sure. I don't think it's Nasty Plot with Volt Switch, that makes no sense. It could be Incinerate. Could be Incinerate. That's a set I've seen in Auras tournaments. I don't know if NGMP made it, I think NGMP made it. And Senrate set to hit Ferrothorn with Thunderous. I mean, if he doesn't have T-Wave, he can hope that this doesn't have Earthquake, but like I said, Trent might not have a move to break this sub. So this subs again on Trent. Mew doesn't do anything. Tang has HPS, but Tang dies to Fly. That's not the play. So if he doesn't have T-Wave, his only other play is... okay, wow. Maybe he has Roar on this Heatran, and he just hopes this doesn't have Earthquake. But I think this will have Earthquake. I think this has no Dragon Step. Oh god, it doesn't have Earthquake. Wow. Yeah, okay, he doesn't have a move to break this up. The game is over then. If he had Roar, I'm pretty sure he would have clicked it there. But yeah, he has Earthquake. Wow. I thought he doesn't have it. I thought he didn't have it because he subbed first. But that boy just said we're going hard for a game. I don't know if I would have subbed there in case the Heatran had Roar. I probably would have just gone for Earthquake, but I understand why you would substitute. And it works out for Mob, and this is just gonna be a 6-0. I don't see how Ricardo can come back. Feels bad, man. I kinda wanted Ricardo to win, but this is, it's also really cool to see like Salamence put in work in World Cup. And this is just gonna die to a fly. Like plus 3 fly, like plus 4 fly, it's gonna die, yep. And GG. Mobali, I think Ricardo was 2-1 before this, so he's 2-2 now, and Mobali was, I think, 2-2, so he's 3-2 now, but not 100% sure. But yeah, thank you guys for watching, really cool and quick game, unfortunate for Ricardo. And Team Europe is up 2-1 still in this series here, you guys can see. We have some exciting games coming up. We have Pearl versus Lex. I actually don't know who Lex is. Ben Menefee versus Roses. I know Ben Menefee played really well last round, even though his game didn't matter. The song with Bengay is going to be hyped. My man Easy is playing in Auras. I think he, I don't know if he's that happy. I think he wanted to play Sun Moon. But we shall see what happens in the next days. I think the deadline is in 2 or 3 days. I don't remember correct. Yeah, thank you guys for watching. GG to Mobali and the Salamence. I really like the combination of mons that he has. This knockoff Landris to get rid of Shedshell, then Magnezone can trap Skarmory. And if Skarmory is gone, the Salamence puts in work. That's just fire. Like, this team looks really cool to me. I don't know how good it is, but in the specific case, it worked out really well. And yeah, I'll see you guys with more World Cup coverage. Thank you for watching. Have a fantastic day. And Doc signing out. Goodbye.